Good morning and welcome. I am Caitlin McPherson, the UMC Board Chair and a senior majoring in psychology at CU Boulder. The UMC Board is a student-run board that manages the UMC.
Good morning. I'm Josh Sloat, President of the Student Veterans Association and a junior studying mechanical engineering at CU Boulder.
Josh and I will be serving as your MCs today. We'd like to thank you for joining us today in honoring all U.S. veterans and especially Colorado veterans.
Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I would like to recognize a few special guests in the audience today. Members of the Chancellor's Cabinet, Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs, Akira Bradley, and Associate Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs, Andrea Zelenko. Thank you for joining us today.
Before we move on with the ceremony, I'd like to provide some historical context on this day we call Veterans Day. In 1919, President Wilson announced that the 11th day of the 11th month would be known as Armistice Day, and be a day filled with solemn pride in the heroism of those who died in the country's service and with gratitude for the victory. In 1938, this day was made a U.S. federal holiday. In the years between, the American Legion began a tradition of commemorating fallen military members by wearing a red poppy, a tradition inspired by the poem In Flanders Fields and a tradition kept to this day in all Commonwealth countries. After serving in the Boer War, a field surgeon named John McCrae returned to Canada and began teaching at McGill University. When World War I began, McCrae felt compelled to return to service and deployed to Belgium. In 1915, one of his students from McGill was assigned to McCrae's unit and eventually killed in combat. In response to his student's passing, he penned these lines. In Flanders fields, the poppies blow, between the crosses row on row, that mark our place and in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly. Scarce heard amid the guns below, we are the dead short days ago. We lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from failing hands we throw. The torch be yours to hold it high, if ye break faith with us who die. We shall not sleep through poppies grow in Flanders fields. Those lines have been read on this day for a century, even after we changed the name of this holiday in 1954. That year, an act of Congress expanded this day from a day to remember our war dead to a day to honor all veterans. I would like to thank all veterans who are joining us today. Thank you.
Thank you, Josh, and thank you to our veterans. I would like to take a few minutes to talk about the University Memorial Center and its role as the State of Colorado Veterans Memorial. The building many of us know as the Economics Building originally opened in 1930 as the Memorial Student Union of the University of Colorado. It was dedicated to CU students who served and died during World War I, and you can still see their names engraved upon its walls today. The Memorial Student Union served as CU Student Union Building until 1953, when the UMC was opened and dedicated as the new Memorial Center. In 1947, then-Governor William Lee Nouse issued a proclamation that stated, "The Memorial Center at the University of Colorado shall be the official state memorial to those who served and to those who died in these great wars to preserve our democratic freedom." Since the UMC opened in 1953, it has continued to honor our servicemen and women. We take this responsibility bestowed on the UMC with humility and reverence. In 1976, as a part of the State of Colorado's centennial celebration, the Veterans Lounge was created as a joint project between the UMC Board and the CU Veterans Student Association, now called the Student Veterans Association. In 2016, the Veterans Memorial Lounge was expanded to three times its original size and provides a more prominent area in which guests can reflect and honor our nation's and specifically Colorado's veterans. The lounge showcases artifacts from past USS Colorado ships. We received these items through the generosity of the USS Colorado Alumni Association and USS Colorado Commissioning Committee. And we want to thank representatives of these organizations who are with us today.
As we celebrate veterans who are with us today, we also honor those veterans who have passed. In our Veterans Memorial Lounge, we house several artifacts from different conflicts through our history. In addition to these artifacts, the glass walls in the Veterans Memorial Lounge displays the names of the Coloradans who went to war and did not return. For World War I, there are 55 names on the wall. For World War II, 226 names. For the Korean War, 303 names. For Vietnam, 595 names. For the First Gulf War, 4 names. For Iraq, 78 names. For Afghanistan, 40 names. Please join me in a moment of silence for all fallen service members who have made the ultimate sacrifice in serving our country. Thank you. Now I'd like to introduce Stu Elliott, CU Boulder's Director of Veteran and Military Affairs and a Navy SEAL veteran.
Good morning. Thank you for coming here today. I'd like to give a special thanks to the Executive Assistant to the UMC Director, Lauren Fitchner, for the outstanding job she did in setting up this virtual event. I would like to express my sincere thanks to the CU Boulder senior leadership for their continued outstanding support of the CU Boulder Office of Veteran and Military Affairs. It is my distinct honor to introduce the keynote speaker, Bob Schuetze. When I first started working at CU Boulder, I was approached by Bob and some of his colleagues at the Boulder Country Club about doing a golf event to support CU Boulder student veterans. This was new territory for our newly created office, but CU Boulder senior leadership stepped in and supported the idea 100%. Since the beginning of the annual Patriots Day golf tournament, the money raised that goes directly to support CU Boulder student veterans, programming, scholarships, and student aid is over $530,000. Booyah, Bob. After having served on active duty in the Navy for 28 years, my return to the civilian world in Boulder was a new challenge, and I was greatly appreciative of the warm welcome I got from the CU Boulder campus community. Still sometimes feeling a little out of place in Boulder, it was the connection, support, and friendship of Bob Schuetze that really made me feel welcome in our Boulder community. As you can see on Bob's biography, he served as a Naval Air Intelligence Officer on USS America during the Vietnam War. The best story Bob ever told me was about the extremely heroic service of his squadron during intense combat operations over Hanoi, which was the single contributing factor to getting Senator John McCain and his fellow POWs released from captivity and returned to the United States. It's my distinct honor and privilege to introduce the keynote speaker, Mr. Bob Schuetze.
Thank you to Commodore Stu Elliott and the University of Colorado for this opportunity to participate in celebrating our veterans. It is an honor and a privilege to be speaking to you today. And to all our veterans and their families, thank you for your service. I include families of veterans because they give so much to our country as well. Their sacrifice, including the separation, concern and worry, and loneliness that are endured by the spouses, children, and parents of members of our military during long and dangerous deployments, should never be overlooked or forgotten. I served in the U.S. Navy from 1969 to 1977. I did not hear those words of thanks for many years. Vietnam was a very unpopular war, and the military was often vilified instead of honored in the 60s and 70s. I served in the Navy as an air intelligence officer for VA-35, which flew the A-6 Intruder, a low-level bomber aircraft. We deployed aboard the aircraft carrier USS America. In 1972, we went to Vietnam. It was my job to brief the air crews about their targets and the enemy defenses for each of their missions. We flew countless missions over North and South Vietnam. The aircraft fought through a torrent of anti-aircraft fire and surface-to-air missiles. just to give you a little flavor of that, on one particular mission, the A6 would fly in at low level, 500 feet, to avoid enemy radar. It then had to move up to around 6,000 feet to actually do their bombing run. Through that, they would go through at low level, there would be small arms fire, and then they got a little higher and it'd be anti-aircraft. And as soon as they got high enough, they would be in the danger of surface-to-air missiles. This particular aircraft, after having experienced all of that, when the missiles were fired, they had to go low level to avoid the missile. Then they get back into the anti-aircraft fire, go further low. And in this case, they ran through a tree. When they got back to the aircraft carrier, there were limbs of the tree embedded in the wings and ailerons of the aircraft, and yet they were able to land. In debriefing, when I asked the pilot about what he had encountered and what was the most difficult part of the mission, he said, landing on the aircraft carrier at night. These pilots do that day in, day out. And one of the most dangerous parts of their mission is landing on an aircraft carrier at night. In September of that year, our squadron commanding officer, Commander Vern Donnelly, was shot down over North Vietnam, along with his bombardier navigator, Lieutenant Commander Ken Buell. Commander Donnelly's remains were returned to his family many years later. Lieutenant Commander Buell is still missing in action. They paid the ultimate sacrifice for their country. Serving in the military is the ultimate patriotic act. Fighting in an unpopular war with little or no civilian support challenges that patriotism in a way our country had never experienced. The wall that Josh mentioned earlier, showing the Coloradoans that have been lost in service to our country, the names for North or for the Vietnam War are more than all of the names combined for the two world wars and Korean War. It demonstrates what an impact the Vietnam War had on our country. We all knew that this war was a losing proposition, yet we continued to do our duty to the highest level of our ability. Our only hope seemed to be to obtain the release of the POWs and finally bring them home. This is what kept us going. Our bombing efforts continued and gave the US negotiators the leverage they needed. On January 27, 1973, they signed the Paris Peace Accords and the POWs released in February. 2 months later, we arrived home to our base in Virginia Beach, Virginia. When we got out of our aircraft after having flown off the carrier, there standing on the tarmac was a group of recently released POWs. Leading that group was Captain Jeremiah Denton. It was an extraordinary experience to be greeted and thanked by these former POWs who had endured so much. Captain Denton was an A6 pilot who was shot down early in the war and was held captive for 7.5 years. He endured torture and unbearable conditions, and yet he met every day with courage and bravery. When his captors trotted him out in front of TV cameras in 1966, he blinked in Morse code the word torture. As part of my training as an intelligence officer, I went through a simulated POW camp run by the South Vietnamese military. Yes, we were tortured and it was horrible, but it only lasted 36 hours. To this day, I cannot conceive of enduring such treatment for 7.5 years. Yet Captain Denton never broke, never wavered from his duty as a naval officer, and never gave up on the country he loved. In spite of disabling injuries received in captivity, he continued to serve our country in the Navy, becoming an admiral and then U.S. Senator for the state of Alabama. He and Senator McCain are true American heroes. Denigration of a veteran because they were a prisoner of war is unforgivable and cannot be accepted. One thing I would like you to think about today is not only thanking a veteran for their service, but more importantly, understanding the depth of that service, the extraordinary sacrifice, bravery, suffering, and dedication to duty that they have so unselfishly given to all of us to preserve our freedom. 4 months after returning from Vietnam, I entered law school while still on active duty. That transition from war to academic life is difficult. In the 70s, it was made more difficult by an unsympathetic public. I was more fortunate than so many of my fellow Vietnam veterans. PTSD and emotional trauma were unrecognized back then. Veterans had to fight for the treatment for their injuries. They were not only forgotten, they were cast aside. Our men and women in uniform were often vilified, even spit upon. We do better now, but one thing I would like you to remember today is to never let that happen again. I am thankful that things are much different today. I am grateful that the University of Colorado has been a leader in its support of our veterans and active duty military in Boulder. In 2013, retired Navy Captain Stuart Elliott, a 28-year Navy SEAL, was hired to be the Director of Veteran and Military Affairs. Since that time, he has created an office that provides real help to veterans transitioning from military service to student life. His office provides scholarships, emergency financial relief, counseling, tutoring, help with obtaining VA benefits, and the summer and winter bridge programs. These efforts have received national acclaim. However, these services and programs are not funded by auxiliary dollars or student fees. None of these programs would be possible without the generosity of donors. As Stu mentioned, in 2014, a group of us from Boulder Country Club met with Stu to see how we could help with the student veterans at CU. It quickly became apparent that funding was needed to provide much needed help. We started a charity called Colorado Veterans Support. It is a completely voluntary organization with no paid staff. Our primary fundraising is made on a Patriots Day golf event. Since 2014, we have raised over $500,000, all of which has gone to support our student veterans. This year, we did a virtual event and we're actually able to raise over $60,000 just through the generosity of people that want to support student veterans at CU. Others have followed suit, including the Anschutz Foundation and the Phillips 66 Corporation. Please consider donating to help our student veterans. You can donate through Colorado Veterans Support at www.patriotsday.org or contact Amy Westfeld at the University Office of Parent Giving and Boulder Advancement Programs. If we help lift up these student veterans for a successful return to civilian life, we are all lifted up. On a personal note, when I first met with Stu, he said, "Thank you for your service." For years, I really couldn't accept that thanks. I was bitter and angry about the war in Vietnam, about losing my friends and squadron mates to a war that seemed useless. When Stu told me those words, it changed things for me. Again, I began to respect and love my naval service. And since that time, Stu has continued to support that. And so the Office of Military and Veteran Affairs at CU not only helps student veterans, it helps veterans all across the board. And I feel very thankful for that. It's interesting what they always say about doing some charitable act. The real benefit is what you get back. And that's what I've received back. And I sincerely appreciate it. And thanks go to Stu and CU. I would like to leave you with this quote. A veteran, whether active duty, discharged, retired, or reserve, is someone who at some point in his life wrote a blank check made payable to the United States of America for an amount up to and including their life. Thank you for today, and God bless our military men and women currently serving overseas.
Thank you, Mr. Schuetze. Before we end, I would like to invite all attendees to take a virtual tour of our Veterans Memorial Lounge and its artifacts after the ceremony. A link to the video will be available in the chat and on the UMC website. We want to thank the UMC Board, University of Colorado Student Government, the Office of Veteran and Military Affairs, the Student Veterans Association, and each of you from the campus and community for your support of all veterans. It allows us to continue to recognize and honor our student, staff, faculty, and community veterans for their service and sacrifice. Thank you again for joining us today and honoring all those who have served.